GDP is often used as an indicator of welfare or well-being, the implication being if GDP is growing, everyone must be happy. This is not true. It's literally just how much stuff got made. Hi, I'm Matt.
And I'm Richard.
And we're economists.
All right, we've got a question here about the GDP figures. They've come out for the March quarter. So the March quarter is January, February, March. What do they show?
Well, before we talk about what they show, let's talk about what GDP is. GDP, gross domestic product, is the main sort of measure that we use in Australia to describe how big the economy is and often how fast it's growing. So gross domestic product is talking about how much product, how much stuff got made within our domestic borders within Australia. So gross domestic product, how much stuff got made in Australia between the period January, February, March this year. And it's often used, GDP is often used as an indicator of welfare or well-being, the implication being if GDP is growing, everyone must be happy. This is not true. It's literally just how much stuff got made. And whether the stuff that's getting made is homes for the homeless or holiday homes for the holiday homeless, whether it's food for hungry people or restaurant meals for people who eat out every night, GDP doesn't care. It just adds up the value of all the stuff that got made. So Matt, what happened in the March quarter?
GDP went up for the quarter by 1.8%, but if you look at the last 12 months, it's only actually increased 1.1%, which is because we had the big recession, right?
So it tanked last year,
yep,
and now it's starting to grow.
And what it means is that now that we have a yearly growth of 1.1%, it means we've actually passed the level of GDP in March last year, which means the beginning of the recession.
So the economy is now bigger than it was before COVID hit, a little bit.
You might think, well, that means the end of the recession and everything's fine. But what it actually means is we've lost a year of economic growth. Like the economy, if we hadn't had the recession, would have been much higher after a year of growth. We've only really gotten back to where we were a year ago.
So if I'd got a pay cut and then I got a pay rise, I'm not as well off as if I never got the pay cut and got the pay rise.
Exactly right. So what was contributing to growth? Well, households, as always, mostly, are a big part of the economy. I think they make up 60% of GDP, and household spending increased. But interestingly, government spending decreased this quarter.
Decreased?
Yeah.
So are they trying to stimulate the economy?
Well, exactly right. But remember, it's a change from last quarter. So we know that the government it hasn't completely cut all stimulus. It has reduced the amount of stimulus. For the March quarter, we saw JobKeeper decrease, the amount of JobKeeper paid decreased. And the government has basically been withdrawing stimulus. So the amount of extra money coming in from the government has actually been falling.
So they're still pumping money into the economy, but not as much as they were last year.
That's right. And also, because JobKeeper in the March quarter went down, interestingly, business profits also actually fell.
Because a lot of JobKeeper was actually more profit keeper than JobKeeper.
Exactly right. This is the first recession we've ever had in Australia's history where profits went up during the recession.
Good time to own a company.
Exactly right. We also had a big increase in this weird category that people don't often look at called inventories. And it was a massive increase. So for the quarter, GDP increased by 1.8%. 0.7% of that, so, you know, just under half of it, that increase, was due to inventories.
Doesn't inventory mean stuff stored in a warehouse somewhere?
Exactly right. So it's stuff that we've made, that's already been produced, but it hasn't yet been sold.
So unsold stuff in warehouses is driving the economy at the moment.
Exactly right, which is really weird. And often inventories can jump around a bit. They don't have a great way of measuring inventories, I don't think. But often inventories actually mean that we're coming up, or an increase in inventories means we're coming up to a problem. That is, firms are producing more than they're selling, and so they've misunderstood how much demand there is out there in the economy.
You're being a bit glass half empty, aren't you, Matt? I mean, couldn't the inventory mean that firms are expecting big sales in the coming year, so they're stockpiling the stuff they need now?
That could be the case too. So
I guess we're going to have to wait and
see. We'll wait and see. So one quarter change in inventories, I wouldn't necessarily get super excited about.
But it's a big part of this latest number.
Yeah, it's almost half the increase in GDP comes from inventories. The other big driver was business investment. Business investment was up this quarter, which again is unusual in a recession or in the early parts of a recovery. But what was most fascinating was the bits of business investment. The largest increase came from machinery and equipment.
So all the enormous subsidies we're giving for people to go and buy big utes,
yep,
they're working.
Yeah, exactly right.
We're going to have a ute-led recovery.
If we have lots of businesses buying utes, then this will go up. And the other large part was residential property, dwellings, also increased.
Right, so we've got lots of investment in new utes, lots of investment in new houses. The utes and new houses will really set Australia up for a prosperous export-oriented economy in the years to come. Is that what you're saying?
Not necessarily. So this is not broad spectrum investment increases. This is very localized and in stuff that you kind of feel isn't going to be sustainable in the long run.
So inventory's up,
yeah,
utes up.
Yeah, so we're getting
house construction up.
So while 1.8% increase in GDP looks impressive, it is underneath there are some problems.
You could say this is a patchy recovery.
Patchy recovery, I think, is the euphemism people love to use. But the other thing, going back to business investment, is the construction industry. If we just look at the construction industry, it increased this quarter, but it still hasn't actually increased to pre-pandemic levels.
So there's more construction activity than when there was in the middle of the crisis, but not as much as there was this time last year.
Yeah, so the economy as a whole, on average, is now above its pre-pandemic, but construction isn't.
Oh well, we'll have to keep watching the data and see what happens next.